Hello everybody, how are you all? I'm Amrita Kar, back here to conduct today's English class. And for this class, there will be three videos. So keep a watch on all of them. We have started with a story named The Missing Prizes. I hope you all are enjoying reading these stories. So many animals are there, isn't it? It talks about the missing prize which went missing. Did someone take or actually it fell off from the table? You know the story very well. In this video 1, we will do vocabulary words from list 1. Let's learn the vocabulary words from list 1 from the story The Missing Prizes. Let's begin. Which word can you see here? The word is us. Children, please repeat after me. The word is us. What is the meaning of the word us? The word us is used to refer himself or herself along with other people. It means ourselves as well. Now, let us use the word us in a sentence. Look at the picture. What can you see? You can see few children. And what are they doing? Don't you feel they are enjoying the rain? Let's see in which sentence I have used the word us. The sentence is, let us enjoy in the rain. So what is the sentence? Let us enjoy in the rain. Let us move to the next slide. The word is let. Children, please repeat after me. The word is let. What does let mean? Let means to allow. Let's look at the image to understand the word better. What can you see here? You can see a teacher and few children around her. And you can see her flipping the pages of a book. So, how have I used the word let in a sentence? See that. I have used the word let in a sentence like, let us read aloud. The teacher is saying, everybody, let us read aloud. That's a good habit, isn't it? The word is ent. What does ent mean? Ent refers to final part of something. Or it refers to finished as well. Let's look at the image. What can you see here? You can see a road. And at the end of the road, what can you see? A house. So let's see how I have used the word end in a sentence. The sentence says, my home is at the end of this road. So I want to say that at the end of the road, my home is there. The word is on. Repeat after me. The word is on. It refers to a place or position or the surface area. Look at this image now. What can you see? A girl, right? And where is the girl sitting? She is sitting on a chair. So, I have used the word on in a sentence like, the girl is sitting on a chair. The next word is off. Look at the word and read it. Off. What does off mean? Off refers to away from a place or from somewhere. Let's look at the image. What can you see here? A boy. What was he doing? You can see the cycle. So he was cycling. But right now, what do you feel? What has happened to him? Is he still riding the cycle? No. Let's see how I have used the word off in a sentence. The sentence is, the boy fell off from the bicycle. So, the boy was riding the bicycle but he fell off from the cycle. Let us move on to the next word. The word is here. Children, please look at the word and read it. The word is here. The word here is used to draw attention to something or to refer, or it refers to a nearby place as well. Let's see an image and then we will make a sentence with the word here. Let's look at the image. You can see the image of a cute little boy along with a dog. Let's see how I have used the word here in a sentence. And the sentence says, here is my pet dog named Sam. So the boy is saying, here is my pet dog named Sam. So the name of the dog is Sam. And as the dog is next to the boy, that's why he is using the word here. Let us see which word is waiting for us. The word is bag. Look at the word and read it. The word is bag. Bag is something flexible to carry things. It can be made up of plastic or cloth or canvas. Let's look at the image. You can see a bag here. And I have used the word bag in a sentence like, the color of the bag is pink. The color of the bag is pink. This is the end of video 1.